Welcome to Wrong Time Watch. My name is Kevin, and today we're checking out a Citizen Series 8 890. This is on loan from Saltzman's Watches. Really appreciate them sending over watches for us to check out. I'll leave a link in the description to their website and their Instagram if you go check them out. I greatly appreciate it. Let's get this thing out of here. I don't know the exact model they sent over, so let's check it out. Then I'll follow this up video. I will follow up this video in about a week with the full video. Yeah, it's very cool. It's this is the, I believe it's a limited edition or special edition. I always get those mixed up in my mind, but yeah, very cool watch here. And this is a nicer box than what Citizens normally come in. It feels like a wood box. It's not cardboard, that's for sure. And we can check out the information on the hang tag here. If I have it in the right orientation, there's the model number NB6066-51W, MSRP $1,595. And this is made in Japan. Like I said, this is, I believe it's a limited edition. That's a very cool looking dial. And I had it upside down for some reason. You know, I think watches that have kind of like the symmetrical thing on both sides kind of throws me off, or I don't know. But anyway, let's see if we get this thing wound up. Yep, second hand started taking off there. So the second hand is black, and then the hour and minute hand also have a black outline as well, but they are shiny too, so perhaps it's a polished black steel, blackened steel. Let's see. All right, so we have an inner rotating bezel, and it is bi-directional rotating. This does not screw down. So I say it's probably more for timing than for diving. Man, this thing is cool. First time having one in hand. So it looks like this portion here might be screwed onto the case. Yeah, it looks like a separate piece. Very cool looking watch. Reminds me of the Zenith Defy Classic, or perhaps Audemars Piguet Royal Oak. It's kind of mixture of things going on here. Kind of looks like maybe the Octa Finissimo too. So it's a little bit bigger than I was expecting. See, so that one, I think that'll have to stay on there. Let's try and take it off to put it on wrist, but that hang tag will stay on there. So we have solid end links, solid links. Looks to be held in place with a pin and collar system. Yeah, there's a little arrow on there. I don't think those are split pins. And then it's almost looks like a butterfly clasp, but it's not. That's pretty interesting. I thought it was a butterfly clasp, but it's not a butterfly clasp. But there are not any micro adjustment holes in there. So that's kind of neat. Dual pusher, milled clasp. Alright, let me put this on wrist and then we'll close out the video. If you haven't subscribed yet, please hit that subscribe button. Let me show you a quick side-by-side with the Submariner for size reference. This watch is bigger than I was expecting. I didn't really look at the specs of the size. For some reason, I was thinking it'd be a little bit smaller of a watch, but it's a full-size watch. And then we have the integrated bracelet too. And here's a look at the thickness of it. So yeah, I would say it's probably 12 and a half, 13 millimeter thick. Let's look at the case back. So I would assume that's a Miyota 9000 series movement in there. Let's see what it says. Citizen, water resistant 200 meter. It actually said 20 bar, but it's 200 meter. Magnetic resistant. All right, interesting. Made in Japan. Then maybe a serial number and a model number, 9051 That could be the movement, the 9051 movement. And then let's take a close-up at the dial. Really cool pattern there. It looks kind of like flowers. And then at the bottom you see there, Series A automatic, and then citizen. So, and then I'm not sure if you could tell, but the crown, both crowns are black, different style crowns. So that kind of coordinates with those hands there too, the blackened steel. Yeah, very neat. And we have a mixture of polished and brushed surfaces on the bracelet. All right, let's get this on wrist and we'll close out the unboxing video here. Just taking it all in here. Looks a little big on my 6.5 inch wrist, at least through the camera. Looking at it by my eye, it looks a little bit smaller. I think I could probably pull it off in my 6.5 inch wrist. And that's cool how the chapter ring matches the color of the dial. And then also the indices are this blackened polished steel as well. So it's a nice looking watch all around. And those indices are nice and tall. Nice applied indices in there. Alright, that will conclude this video. As always, thank you for your time and thank you for watching.